Hello everyone, I am Tejan. In this talk, we present LEAD, Self-Supervised Landmark Estimation by Aligning Distributions of Feature Similarity. This is a joint work with Abhinav, Harsha, Sushmit, Varun, and my advisor, Professor Venkatesh. Landmark estimation is the task of learning a model which, when given an image, predicts representative points over it. These points are 2D locations over the image. Generally, these models are trained on a category-specific dataset. The challenges in this task are that of clutter on the object, pose variations of the object, and need for landmark annotation. The annotations are expensive and laborious to obtain, while also being ambiguous due to granularity of the task. This has paved way for self-supervised approaches to learn representations that are useful for landmark estimation. The aim here is to make use of large-scale unannotated dataset of a class of objects, such as faces, to train a model. This model should be capable of finding corresponding landmark given a landmark annotation. This model could also be used as a feature extractor to train a shallow model on a small-scale annotated dataset. Existing methods like DVE follow the principle of equivariance of features across warped images. Recent work of contrast landmarks investigated into the emergence of equivariant representations from contrastive learning-based pretext tasks. DVE's representation does not scale up to improve as the representation dimension is increased. In the case of contrast landmarks, MoCo framework is utilized, which incurs the cost of negative images. In our work LEAD, we ask two questions. Are self-supervised frameworks which do not use negative samples capable of preserving the equivariance? And how can this property be leveraged to guide training of dense and compact representation of an image? As the first stage, we train BYOL framework, where given an image and its two augmentations, predictor network Q takes representation of one augmentation of the image and predicts the representation of the second augmentation. The predicted representation is supervised by momentum average feature extractor phi and feature projector g. The key insight we find in such representation is that it is capable of tracking a point semantically from a source image to a target image. This is achieved by first extracting hypercolumn feature maps of both source and target images. The hypercolumn feature vector corresponding to the point to be tracked in the source image, right eye in this example, can be rolled over the hypercolumn feature map of the target image to find the cosine similarity. The heat map shows the highest similarity with the right eye region in the target image. Since the hypercolumn representation is very high dimensional, we seek to learn a dense and compact representation that can exhibit the same property. We first enhance the feature extractor obtained in stage 1 with an FPN based decoder followed by a projector network G. We take two different images and obtain its dense and compact features F. We then obtain its respective hypercolumn feature maps. Feature maps are then reshaped into matrices, and their feature similarity distribution is obtained by cosine similarity followed by softmax. Since we want dense and compact feature maps to exhibit the property of landmark tracking principle just like the hypercolumn based feature maps, we use cross entropy to match their distribution. We perform experimental evaluation on the standard datasets. We train the model on Celebi, which is large scale unannotated dataset, and then evaluate the performance of the features on annotated MAFL, AFLW, and 300W datasets. We evaluate the performance of stage 1 training on the task of landmark matching. In this task, we are provided with a reference image with landmarks, and these landmarks have to be tracked in the target image. We find that BYOL pre-training is helpful in preserving the landmarks, while MoCo pre-training tends to mismatch them, as can be seen in the contrast landmarks. To individually evaluate the importance of our stage 2 training, we use it on top of contrast landmark stage 1 pre-training, where we observe that irrespective of stage 1 objective, our stage 2 objective improves the pre-trained model's performance. Our method scales up as we increase the number of annotations available for the evaluation, while providing as large as 45% relative gain in the interocular distance metric. Finally, we take a step towards eliminating the need for bounding box annotations to tightly crop the faces. Here we train our model on certain scales of bounding boxes around the image, and observe that it generalizes reasonably well when inferred over extrapolated scales of bounding boxes. To conclude, we report the emergence of landmarks when trained on BYOL framework, which does not use negative images. We utilize this property to learn a dense and compact feature map to reduce dependency over high-dimensional hypercolumns. Our experimental evaluations show the effectiveness of the learned representation over a variety of tasks such as landmark matching and regression, as well as its robustness to annotation availability. Please refer to our paper for more details. Thank you.